Hello and welcome to another Morning Mondays. This is episode 70. And this week, guys, I've been working on another of my Mordian 50th Rifles Command Chimeras. I have to say, I've been really, really enjoying doing these vehicles. I really want to continue restoring more and more vehicles for the Mordian 50th Rifles. But I think it is time to have a little, you know, after this week, to go back to the Orcs for a week or two, because at the same time as I'm getting the itch to paint my Mordians, I've also got that itch to paint the boys. I just, you know, there's something very cathartic about painting Orcs. They're just, they're really, really expressionate models and they're just really cool, so I'm looking forward to that. But that, we'll talk about Orcs next week. Let's focus on the Chimera this week. So, this is another old school Imperial Guard Chimera. This is one, again, it's one of the sort of second, third edition Chimeras. It's got the chunkier side. So for those of you that are wondering, what's the difference when I say an old Chimera versus a new Chimera, right? Some of you are new Imperial Guard players. You've only ever seen what I tentatively call the new Chimera sculpt. It's only new because it's the most recent. It's about 9 years old, but it is technically, you know, the newest sculpt. Basically, the old Chimera, there's been three main iterations of the Chimera sculpt. You've had what I would call, you know, the first one, which is very similar to what you see here, except for all the tracks and wheels for the tracks were individual pieces. So that was really difficult to put together. And then you had the slightly improved version of that, where they changed the shape and style of the top hatch. And they also made the tracks part of sort of one big piece, and the wheels weren't separate parts. It was less of an Airfix kit and more of an easier to put together kit. And then you have the third iteration, which is the most recent one, where they kept that track improvement, but they also changed lots of small things. Well, the sort of couple of main changes where they changed the shape of the turret so it was taller and blockier and fatter, and they changed that it came with more weapon options, not just the multi-laser in the turret, and they also changed the side armor. Now I'm not talking about the side skirts that I've put on, I'm talking about the blocks that protrude from the side of the Chimera. Those used to be a separate piece that you put on because they were a separate upgrade called extra armor, so you didn't have to put them on if you didn't want to. But they're much more pronounced on these older Chimeras. On the newer ones, they are molded on. They're part of that side piece of the tracks. And as you know, if you built one of these things, and they're much less pronounced as well. So just a bit of an interesting thing. And like I said, there's lots of small stylistic changes as well. The way the multi-laser goes in the turret has changed on the new kit. The way the comms array works has changed. Even things as simple as the smoke launchers are slightly different now. And the hunter killer missiles. There's loads of small improvements. So when people say, you know, oh, the guard had the same Chimera kit for a long time, that's not actually true. There has been lots of small changes. I think just you don't appreciate, or appreciate might not be the right word, but you don't fully notice all the changes that have happened with the Chimera kit. Until you actually go all the way back and do one of these old ones where the Hunter Killer is this really wacky, looks a bit like I guess it looks a bit like an Exocet missile. Is it an Exocet or a Saga missile? I'm not sure. It looks like it's much shorter and fatter with really pronounced fins. And then you had the other kind of Hunter Killer missile, which was like the big, which was the box. And the missile went inside the box and it wasn't exposed like it is on this one and the old one. The heavy stubbers changed, the storm bolt changed, loads and loads of bits have changed on the Chimera. We just don't appreciate it because, like I always said, we don't notice it because we see those changes sort of very slowly. You know, the dozer blade's different. Something as simple as the dozer blade is significantly different. It's had like three or four iterations. You've had the old school, like chaos, really small, really, really small spiked dozer blade. And then you had the one that looks similar to the one we've got now, except for it didn't have the bits on the sides. It was just ended. Didn't look as good in my opinion. And then you've got this dozer blade. So it's really interesting how there's all these subtle changes that Games Workshop has made to the Chimera kit. If you put them side by side on a battlefield and from a distance, you wouldn't really notice as an opposing player, and you probably wouldn't really notice as a guard player. But when you actually bring it down, sort of put them next to each other, and you take the time to look at the differences, it's like, wow, yeah, those are actually significantly different kits. You know, the top hatch has changed, the tank command has changed, there's no metal parts anymore. There used to be metal bits in the Chimera kit. Yeah, the guard range, I know a lot of guard players like to moan about how hard done we are. And in some ways, you know, we are. You know, we have had the same Cadian sculpts, we have had the same Chimera sculpts. It seems like we have. But the reality is that essentially the only kit that's remained unchanged for a long time is the Cadian Infantry kit. That has been around since late 3rd edition, and we're on 9th edition now, so we have essentially had the same infantry kit for 6 editions. But the Chimeras and the other vehicles, like the Hellhounds and the Lehman Russ, they've had multiple iterations. So it's just kind of interesting. Like, the guard range has actually received a consistent amount of love. What I would say is that Games Workshop doesn't really provide us with new vehicles or new units very often. I mean, you know, we had the Torox, which is a bit of a I actually like the Torox in person. I just think it looked, I don't know, it doesn't photograph well. Maybe the camera has £10, I don't know. But you know, the Stormtroopers, you know, those were like, you know, those are new kits. But in terms of the way the guard range seems to get a bit of love is we don't get new units very often, but we get updates to our current kits. So we get changed to Chimeras, we get changed to Lehman Russes, we get changed to Hellhounds, we get changed to Hydras. You know, the Hydra used to only be able to get that from Forge World, for example, and it was a really cool looking model, but you could only get it from Forge World. So I think, you know, I'm kind of, you know, it's always nice to get new units, but often when you get new units, they can sideline existing units. The Torox is, and it's just the exception that proves the rule. It was just so wildly unpopular with regular guard commanders that the only way they got people to buy it was to bung it in the Star Collecting Scion kit. And then, you know, it's really good as a Scion transport. It's really nice and it's unique for the Scions. But yeah, the Chimera is one of those weird ones where it wasn't replaced because it's just such an iconic kit that you'd have to have something really special to replace the Chimera. I think Games Workshop kind of knows that, and it's like, well, if we're going to release some new guard kits, what we're better doing is just updating current models rather than releasing whole new ones. But anyway, that's just my theory. I've no proof on that. Just wild speculation. Anyway, So I've completed two of these cameras. I spoke a lot about this last week, which is why I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about the different kits this week. But I really, really enjoyed these models. I really enjoyed putting the side armor on them. So I don't think in last week's video I had the side skirts for these models, and I have got them now. Really, really appreciate and really love what these, using that word a lot, appreciate, really love what these side skirts do for the model. They're absolutely fantastic. They're relatively affordable. They're purely an aesthetic upgrade. I just thought it was really cool to make the Mordian Chimera look just really heavily armored, like a brick of armor, and differentiated from my Armageddon Chimeras, which are much more sort of slim and streamlined. They've got loads of extra equipment hanging off them to represent that they're a rapid reaction force, but the Mordians are not a rapid reaction force. You know, when their armor comes into play, it's to bulldoze the enemy to death. So literally in the case of Dozer Blades. But yeah, I just really, really like this, what the side armor has added to the vehicles. I think it's just really cool. And who knows, it will do something one day. Who knows? It would be cool to have some sort of reactive armor, but maybe it's a little too high tech for the old guard, you know. Although, thinking about it, going off on a totally random tangent here, I know a lot of people, one of the fundamental problems with guard vehicles is we don't have an invulnerable save, and I get it. Invulnerable saves tend to represent one of two things: either a dodge, like you're so fast and maneuverable that you've dodged it, or they represent an energy shield, and the Imperial Guard vehicles do neither of those things. But having some form of reactive armor would be really, really cool. And I think having reactive armor as a thing that you can put on your vehicles, or as a rule that comes with guard vehicles, would be really, really cool. And I think reactive armor having either the ability to reduce damage by one on all guard vehicles who have it would be fantastic, or giving guard vehicles a feel no pain, a shrug save. That would be really, really awesome. I think that is the way you add in a cool rule to the guard. You update them to make them feel a little bit more modern. And for those people who want their guard to be old school and just badass, like World War One, World War Two regiments, they don't have the reactive armor. They can just model it so that they just got really thick slabs of armor plating to really represent just how goddamn durable and how much armor the Imperium just slaps on these things. And it is low tech, it is just loads and loads of armor. So I think that would be really, really cool if they introduced that as a rule to Imperial Guard vehicles. Like, you don't get invulnerable saves. Okay, we're not doing that. That's not very guard. Not even the Baneblade gets one. There's no energy field generator on these things, okay? There's no minus one to hits. There's no shadow fields or anything like that. The guard is known for having thick slabs of armor. Toughness doesn't represent that enough, okay? It doesn't. But what does represent the guard having just really thick slabs of armor is the fact that they reduce damage, or that they have a feel no pain. And then that can be represented in so many different ways. I mean, at the end of the day, if a Goliath truck, a Genestealer Cult civilian vehicle that's been used for mining, is so durable it gets a special rule called Rugged Construction, which gives them a 6-up feel no pain, a 6-up shrug, then, and then you've got the Achilles Ridge Runner, which has a flare launcher, which literally is designed to, like, you know, I don't know if it's designed to launch flares to intercept enemy ballistics, or if it's designed to just distract the enemy, but that gives them a 6 to feel no pain. If the cult have that, then the guard should definitely have really thick slabs of armor, and they should have the ability to, you know, to reduce damage, and they should have the ability to get a feel no pain. I'm happy to pay for it. I'm happy, you know, for that to be a points thing. I just think that would be really, really cool. Anyway, this has been a bit more of a fixing the rules video. The one last thing I wanted to mention about these chimeras from an actual sort of modelling and hobby thing, and like I said, I covered that a lot last week, so I wanted to just throw out some just cool, wacky ideas for the chimera and just talk a bit about the history of the chimera in this week's video. But one thing I did want to point out, which I only really noticed, and I didn't notice this on all of my Steel Legion chimeras, but I noticed it on these chimeras, it's just how comically oversized the Chimera searchlight is. And that's why I included this picture of them two side by side. Not only so you could see that I've done two, but also if you look at the Chimera searchlight, the one that is on the proper one, which is stuck to the side of the turret, and it's in the comparison picture, it's the one that's on the left-hand side. It's so massive, that searchlight. Now, I don't know if that's realistically proportioned, but I have to say, I really prefer the look. I really prefer the look of the Sentinel searchlight when it's put on the Chimera. I think that looks more realistic. Maybe I'm wrong. When you imagine those big World War II searchlights that they used to use for picking aircraft out of the sky, those were big. But I guess why would a Chimera have like an aircraft-sized, you know, an anti-aircraft-sized searchlight on it? I just thought it looked really funny, and when you put the two side by side, I really, really do prefer the one that's mounted from the Sentinel kit. That's the other thing that I added this week to the first camera show. I said it didn't have a searchlight and I added it. One other thing to mention is I actually, to keep these two semi-consistent, I actually replaced the top hatch from this. It's not a Chimera hatch, it is a Rhino hatch, because it matches very closely the old school hatch that the, you know, second and third edition Chimeras, sorry, the first and second iteration of the Chimeras, it matches their hatch, and the hatch on the current Chimeras is very, very different. I just thought it was cool just to, if I've got these old school Chimeras, I want to try and replicate those hatches where I need to repair them. But yeah, it was really fun doing another Chimera. I've got two of them now. Next week we'll be doing an Orky video, but I've just really can't wait to get back on to doing more guard vehicles and more guard infantry. You know, I feel like I need to do the orcs because they were, you know, they were bought for me, they were present, and I want to show, you know, I want to show gratitude for that. But man, I've got that guard itch bad, you know. I got it bad. Yeah, I baby got bad, you know. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think down in the comment section below. Let me know any other differences between the chimeras that I haven't mentioned on the various iterations. I think the searchlight, you know, the searchlight used to look different as well. Anyway, let me know what your favourite iteration of the chimera is. I'm partial. I prefer the, what I would call the second iteration, where they sort of made the building a bit easier and it doesn't look quite as wacky. And, you know, I quite like that. But I have to say, quite like taking some of the newer parts and adding it to the older chimeras. You know, the old hunter killers used to look a bit crap. I like the new hunter killers. The old comms array used to look be a bit big. I like the newer ones. You know, the searchlights look better. You know, even the ones that come with the kit look better than the old ones, which just used to look wacky and had like weird like razor spines on them. All these kind of things. Anyway, and just let me know what you think. You know, I guess I like the old chimera hole, but I like the new chimera extra bits. Let me know what you guys think. Thank you for watching. Let me know your hobby progress, and of course, I'll see you guys next time.